see you, and we are meeting after quite some time.
Yes, Anna. Likewise.
Sir, firstly, I would like to tell you that if there is something on social media currently, right now, it's all kehne ko hamsafarati and people are going crazy talking about you all the time. How does that feel?
Well, when you do a piece of work and, you know, we work for our audience because, you know, they are the end consumers. And whenever we are working, the thought is always that, you know, they should like what we are doing. And when they like it and when they love it and when you get the adulation, to aisa kaha jata hai ki ek kalakar ke liye taaliyon ki gadgadahat se badi koi cheez nahi hoti.
Absolutely.
So it's like that. I am humbled. I'm grateful for the love that they have shown us for this season.
Absolutely. And so people are asking for more. They are like waiting for the remaining episodes, and even some of them are talking about season 4 abhi se.
So, well, season 4 ka to pata nahi, lekin I think the balance episodes should be on, I'm told, on the 1st of July. So yeah,
that's awesome, and that's great news for your fans, I must say. Sir, something I want to ask you, that right from the time when we used to watch you as Mihir, as Mr. Bajaj, from that time to now, kehne ko hum safar hai, sir, how do you see your popularity has remained unchanged, is what we can see, that this is sheer magic that you have just kept it like that, your popularity. Sir, how do you see your journey?
Well, I don't know. I cannot see my own journey, and there is no magic that I have done. It's just, you know, it's never a single person. The producers that I'm working with, the directors that I'm working with, they considered me capable of doing the roles that were written by you know, an author, by a writer. So it's everybody has contributed to my success or my journey. So, you know, it's never a one-man effort. It's everybody's effort put in. Again, I'll say I'm just grateful, and I consider myself extremely lucky to be in this situation. And I know some of my audience is growing every day, and I know part of my audience that has been there since Kyunki and Kasoti, and they are still there. They were young girls and boys when they started watching me. Now they are married, they have kids, and they are still watching me. They're still sending me messages. So it feels wonderful, and I hope that this will stay, you know, the way it is for the years to come.
Sir, to add to what you just said, because at that time it was the social media was not there where we could express. Now you also can see what your fans are writing, because directly it is coming via social media to you.
Right. Yes. Well, we didn't have social media then, but we did have other, you know, we had SMSs and various ways of getting
fan mails,
information.
Maybe.
Fan mails, and you know, we had phones at that time, and you know, letters, and like you said, fan mail. So one used to get to know everything. And yeah, today the transference of information is definitely faster than sending it via pigeon courier.
Absolutely. Sir, one thing I would like to ask you, that we experienced a lockdown and we are opening up in phases, and shooting is also about to begin. Sir, as an actor, what do you feel that maintaining social distancing, how difficult is it for an actor to shoot? How will it be on the sets? Do you keep thinking about it? What are your feelings about it?
See, currently I just have 2 projects on floor. And neither producer has called me to ask me for my dates. it is uncertain when they will call me. Maybe they are still watching and waiting for some clarity. Maybe they are waiting for the uncertainty to go away. As far as the other units that want to start shooting, maybe some people have unfinished work. They want to finish their work. Maybe they want to start shooting. I'm not clear about what steps they are going to take. But I feel it's a personal feeling, so I don't know whether it will happen or not. I personally feel that units will become smaller, because you cannot have a 150 people strong unit and expect social distancing. That does not happen. You know, if you make a line of 150 people 6 feet away, that line, so it's not possible. So units will become smaller. Of course, steps will be taken to disinfect the premises and disinfect people somehow. I see no way of disinfecting a virus carrier. So if somebody is carrying a virus and is asymptomatic, there is nothing you can do about it. At least currently, you know, the recording of any such measure is not there. It's not available. So if something is not available, something that, you know, we are all getting information in real time. So what the medical researchers know, that even the common man has the same information. So we all know that the vaccine is being developed. We don't know when it will be there. We all know that some medications are working, but clarity on which medication exactly is not there. So hence, there's a lot of uncertainty. I don't know how this will be possible and whether it will be 100% foolproof. I don't think it will be 100% foolproof. When you're out in a social gathering, your exposure to the disease, your exposure to the virus goes up. The percentile of exposure goes up. So you will be exposing yourself. So this is something that one will have to do. And then how we are learning every day, we are learning new things every day. Maybe once we do it, there'll be something. I'm hoping that there'll be a positive way out of this. And I'm hoping that not just the film industry, but everybody else who's stuck at home without their livelihoods can go back to work. I'm hoping that that way is found soon.
Absolutely. Because, sir, we can all see that there are several actors who have not got paid, not just actors, technicians and others who are related to the industry are not getting paid. They are having a tough time to deal with it. And as you recently mentioned in an interview that you are also taking care of 100 families and you're going through a lot to do that because you haven't been working for quite some time. Sir, I really salute you for what you're doing. And so one thing I want to know from you, that how do you plan to keep this going unless and until you resume work in full swing? What plans do you have?
Well, ma'am, I have, you know, there are things that I had saved up my money in. So as far as that will last, you know, I will keep doing what I'm doing. Today, I have received payment from, you know, from someone. So that will help. So slowly as offices are opening up, you know, some money is coming in. Eventually, I feel that I'm just the medium and it's their destiny also. There is a God somewhere. So I'm just a medium. It's coming from somewhere and it's going to somebody. So I have whatever I have saved up. You know, I know that I will make money in the future. This is not the time to think of all that. This is the time to take care of those people. And, you know, till whenever I can, I will do so.
Absolutely. And sir, this is really appreciable. I find it worth appreciable what you're doing. It's a noble deed. and may God bless you for that.
Thank you. But it's, you know, apart from nobility and things like that, thanks for saying that, but it's my responsibility. You know, some of these people have been with me for 15 months. Some of these people have been with me for 15 years. So what do I do? Do I show them my back? Let's say just one of my drivers. One driver, they're both in their villages right now. They're not on duty. They haven't been on duty for the past 2.5 months. I sent them mid-March, I sent them away. One driver has been with me for 12 years. The other driver has been with me for 9 years. So at a time like this, what do I say to them? That you take care of yourself? No, it's my responsibility. I have to take care of them. Similarly, there are a whole lot of other people, you know, that I'm connected to. And like I'm taking care of them, I'm sure God will find somebody to take care of me. And that's the way it will work. You know, the powerful have to take care of the less powerful. And the less powerful have to take care of the people with no power. It's simple.
Okay. I'm talking about a different topic altogether. From what I can see from your social media, fans are in awe of Ronit Roy in a different avatar. Fans are loving you as the saxophone player. Yeah, and sir, I'm very curious to learn about your journey, how your love for saxophone began and when.
So, you see, I somehow, even as a child, I had always liked the saxophone. Some 5 years, 5 or 6 years back, I had visited New York with my family. And we went to a music store. You know, just like that, we just walked into the music store and they were selling saxophones. And out of a whim, I just bought one. And, you know, I tried to play it and then all kinds of bad sounds came out of it. And then on and off, I tried. And then, because of this lockdown, I said, okay, now let's do something. So I started playing, but not very nicely. Because of the lockdown, then I brought it out and I said, let me, I think for about a year, year and a half, I had ignored it and was just lying there in my room. So I brought it out and, I went to YouTube and I looked for some lessons. And then that
you have learned it only online?
Yeah, from YouTube.
Okay, that's amazing. I thought you must be consulting a teacher or someone.
So there's a lot on YouTube and the people who are teaching on YouTube are actually teachers and it's kind of them, you know, that they are putting out these free lessons on YouTube. Okay. So there's a lot there. So I'm just thinking that before I take formal training, you know, at least YouTube is something that I can access at my own time, because I'm the only man in the house right now. So there's a lot to do in the house. A fixed timing for a class might not work for me right now. I'm trying to kind of take in all the classes that are there on YouTube. And then once I think I'm a little ready, then yeah, we'll take formal classes.
That's amazing. And sir, we hope to see you playing the saxophone sometime on the screen as well.
Oh, well, if somebody writes a role like that, why not?
Sir, one last question for today. Today is a day for child labor, a message against child labor, the rights against child labor. Sir, if you would like to share a message for your viewers.
See, children are supposed to be in school. Children are supposed to be playing in parks, playing in gardens with their friends after school, and then studying. And, you know, they are supposed to be leading a children's life. Children are not supposed to go to work. It is very sad that, this is happening. I am completely against it, and I believe it's illegal also. So I don't know what brings this around. I think, and I'm very sad to say that maybe it's the poverty that everybody is facing. But you know, I'm all I can say is I cannot, you know, physically manifest anything against it. But I am absolutely, I believe that a child should be leading a child's life and not an adult's life. A child should not be made to go to work.
Absolutely. I totally agree with you on that, sir. And it was lovely talking to you.
Likewise,
have a great day,
likewise.
Sir.
Thank you. Talk
Thank
to you,
you
sir.
And take care.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
Bye-bye.